What's up, guys? Saiyan here, bringing you a tutorial on how to be able to get Nox Player and how to be able to play Ridge Racer Slipstream on Nox Player. So, before we get started, I want to say a couple of things. I'm going to show you guys how to be able to get Nox Player simply from the browser itself. Basically, if you search up Nox Player, you're going to be able to find like different versions of Google Log or whatever. You're going to download the 64-bit version depending on your hardware or your graphics card or whatever the case may be. And the reason why we're downloading Nox Player today is because it's the only one that I've tested out so far that actually does work. I haven't really tested out on any other emulator, but the only reason why I haven't tested it out thoroughly like that is because Nox Player is Android 9 beta versus the other ones. And if anybody knows, Richard's Slipstream cannot be played on anything above Android 9. So what you're going to do is you're going to install it, and obviously I have it installed already, and you're going to open up Nox Player. And I'm going to show you my settings real quick, so that way you guys can be aware of it. It's going to show the Android screen, kind of basic stuff. So what you're going to do is, real quick settings, I have my settings set to CPU 4 core and 8 megabyte memory, sorry. Enhanced compatibility mode, OpenGL, and then tablet mode, 1920 by 1080. You do it whatever your setting is there for, or what you want it set to, sorry. You could choose to put the frame rate at 120 or 60 FPS. It's your choice, but in my personal opinion, I would leave it at 60 because for Ridge Racer Slipstream, there's problems with the controller support, or at least keyboard, or whatever your preference really is. I turned off mouse accelerator because it has a issue with drifting and everything else, especially when you're using a controller and so forth. The device you're going to be using is an S9 Plus. No mobile number or anything else needed and stuff like that. The display, it's up to you. You can choose. I mean, that's just above your preference or whatever the case is. Everything else of that nature, but yeah. So what you're gonna need for this particular situation is you're gonna need WinRAR. And the reason why you're gonna need WinRAR is because WinRAR is something that, you know, is gonna make it a lot easier for you to be able to compress or not to compress the files, but at least transfer the files to your OBB folder. But just in case you guys do get lost and you guys, this is your first time, I'm gonna show you something. So when you download this, it's not going to come with the OBB folder. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to go to your storage, Android, and then create the folder and create it to OBB as set here. And then after that, after WinRAR is installed, you're going to go to the browser and you're going to go to this particular website, in which I'm going to leave in the description. Download these two files, not the APK, the modded APK, and this. Don't worry, it's going to be in English. You're not going to have a problem with that. And then once these files are done downloading, you're going to go here, close that, and you're going to go to WinRAR. And as I stated before, download, and you're going to click on the cache one. You're not going to want to install the mod APK first because we need the files to be able to render. If you install it without the actual files for it, what's going to happen is that it's going to leave you at the screen, and it's going to tell you that it can't download files because obviously a Slipstream is offline. So you're going to click on it, you're going to get the file, you're going to browse the destination, you're going to go to Android OBB, put it there, and then after it's done downloading, then you get the APK install that, and then after that's installed, voila, the game works as so. And I know most of you guys probably, you know, you wanted to find a way to play it or whatever. But just in case you guys don't believe that this actually does work, I'm going to play one particular race. And I'm going to just do it because I browsed past it or whatever. I browsed through it. You know, I think it runs like a charm. Now, it's going to have some issues to where it crashes here and there and stuff like that. But I think it only happens like one or two times. So. But as you can see, the game looks really smooth. the gameplay obviously has a bit of cleanness to it. Obviously you can put the textures if you want to. It's completely up to you. It is completely your choice on how to put those textures in there. I don't think it makes much of a difference. I mean, because the gameplay itself already looks smooth as it is. But if you want to do that within the settings, that is your personal choice. Obviously, you see that the game works just fine. I have my controller set, my Xbox controller set to change the views. Keep in mind that this is a modded version of the game. And I think that, you know, you could be able to purchase any car. I mean, that's kind of what the purpose of this was. So if this was very helpful for you, give it a like, subscribe to the content, and or at least subscribe to the channel, that is. And I hope this was very helpful for you guys. I'll see you in the next video, and peace out.